I'm here to prove to my daughter Tiffany and also to my wife that I did not molest my granddaughter. My granddaughter started doing things that I told my daughter she needed to watch out for. And then a couple months later, it came about to being my accusation saying that I had been doing something. Back in July, last July, my wife told me that I was being accused of molesting my granddaughter. My daughter Tiffany took her to the emergency room and she made an accusation that I was doing the things wrong to her, and I'm here to prove that I'm not that animal. I love my granddaughter. I've been in her life for 4 years now, and it's been a blessing. Tiffany says that I touched her at one time, and I'm here to prove that I didn't do that also. I found her outside my house, in front of my house, in a running vehicle with her pants all the way down to her ankles. I pulled them up, helped her in the house. I love her, she's my daughter, and I would never do nothing like that. It really hurts me because I can't be in my granddaughter's life. I can't be around her. I mean, it's really, she loves me and I love her and I miss her. I really miss her a lot. I can't put it into words. The feelings that come, just can't do it. I would never do that, Tiffany. And I hope you know that. And I hope this test can prove to you that I will never ever do it to you or my granddaughter.
Tiffany, that's your father, John, on the tape. How have these accusations affected your relationship with him?
I don't talk to him anymore. It's been almost a year now. We used to have a great relationship. We would do almost everything together, hang out every other night.
So you guys were very close before these accusations came out.
Yeah, definitely. He watched my kids. I worked all the time. I was a single mom. And he was the one to always watch my kids.
Before this, did you ever think, yeah, my dad's kind of creepy or he, you know, was doing something that he shouldn't?
Yeah, but not towards her. You know, it was, he just gives off that creep vibe. Like, I wouldn't have my friends really come around him, any of my girlfriends.
And why is that? What led you to feel that way?
The way he looks at him, you know, just certain things that he would say, like, man, if I was 20 years younger, or, you know, just anything like, you look healthy, or, I don't know, it's just the vibe.
Okay.
You know.
Have you ever directly asked your father, hey, did you do anything to my daughter?
No, I just distanced myself. I immediately went to the cops, and I told my mom that I was going to the cops. I didn't have the heart to talk to him. I remember there was a time where I dressed up cute and I was wearing long socks and tight shorts and a tank top. And he said that I looked really good and that he would really like to take a picture of me. Yeah, I just want answers. Like, I mean, she wouldn't say that you did that if you didn't do that. And I have to live with her all the time, like every day, and see the things she's doing. It's not right.
No, it's not. I love you, sis. I wouldn't do nothing like that to you or my granddaughter. You're my life. You're my world. I miss you so much. I hope this test will prove that I didn't do this and I'm not the monster. Make me out to be. I love you.
I hope so too.
Why would your granddaughter say that you're touching her?
I don't know. She was gripping my hand, and the same thing she was doing to her. And I told her, you need to watch out. She's doing things.
So she did the same thing that Tiffany said that she was doing.
To me.
But to you, she's taking your hand.
But yes. You didn't say that until after I already said something about it. You're like, oh, she was doing that to me, too.
Tiffany, you're saying he never told you this before you said it.
Yes.
No, because I would have asked her, like, who's doing that to you? I didn't have to ask her. She told me.
Were you ever questioned by the police or DCSS?
Yes, and I wouldn't fill out a statement to you.
And
DFS hasn't got back with me at all.
But it's been a long time.
A long time, yes.
Yeah. Now your daughter Tiffany tells a story about 3 years ago. She was at a bar. She became very intoxicated. And at some point, she woke up with different clothes on.
Now, I don't know if she woke up with different clothes on or not. When I took her upstairs, helped her get upstairs, she had urinated on herself, and she took her pants off and everything and laid down in the bed. I went back up to make sure she was all right. I just threw the cover on her and left. That's my daughter. You don't do that.
I need to know if my husband, John, is guilty of molesting my granddaughter and my daughter. Last July, my daughter, Tiffany, called me up and told me that she thinks my husband, John, has been touching my granddaughter, and she was taking her to the hospital to get her checked out. Tiffany told me my granddaughter had been putting Tiffany's hand between her legs. Tiffany told her to stop, and she continued to do it. And she said, "Why are you doing that? Stop doing that." She said, "Well, Grandpa does it all the time." And she said, "What do you mean?" And she said, "Papa puts his hand between my legs all the time, like it was not a big deal." So kind of red flags for her, and she took action. When me and Tiffany talked about this, I had brought it up to her that I was uncomfortable about the fact that a few times that she was a 21, 22-year-old girl, 23, and she got a little too drunk a few times, and he was the one at home taking care of her. And I think he took advantage of her a few times when she was too drunk to know what was going on. During the 30 years that we've been together, John has done some very questionable things, exposing himself to some of my friends, touching some of my friends. One friend, he may touch him. I work two jobs and I'm not home much, but I do know my husband watches a lot of porn, and we're really wondering whether he has watched porn with my granddaughter in the room, or if he's exposed her to any of that. So that's another question that we have. We've been split up for 3 years. I'm in a process of filing for divorce. I just don't have the money right now. If he comes back guilty, he's obviously going to have to leave the house, but I don't know how things are going to work yet. It just, my life is just a shambles right now. Being a victim myself of child molestation through my whole childhood, this is something I talked to my daughter about when she was younger, and I tried to steer her the right way, let her know nobody touches you. You always come to me if anybody, you know, and she's always been, you know, honest with me, and I've not had any problems. But now I feel like I failed because I'm not protecting her and the grandbaby, and it's really hard on me. You know, I just don't really know what's gonna happen, so. We're just here for answers.
I'm just devastated that this is a cycle that's repeating itself, you know, through the family, and it's time for it to stop. It's got to change.
So he came here, took a lie detector test to prove, or, you know, to get to the bottom of the truth. So we asked him, on that night 3 years ago when Tiffany got drunk, did you change her clothes? He answered no. He did not tell the truth.
I didn't change her
clothes. Yep, of course.
I didn't change her at all.
I woke up in different clothes.
You must have put them on your cell phone. I didn't do it.
Did you ever watch pornography with your 4-year-old granddaughter? He answered no. He did not tell the truth.
I knew it.
I didn't do that.
You wouldn't be doing that stuff.
I didn't do that.
Oh, my God. She would have been doing it.
I didn't do that.
Did you ever touch your daughter, Tiffany? Did you ever touch your daughter, Tiffany, for your own sexual gratification? He answered no. He did not tell the truth.
Oh, my God!
I didn't do that. Oh, my God.
And John, you said you believed Steve Wilkos.
I didn't do that, guys.
All the time.
I did not do that.
John, did you ever touch...
I didn't change her clothes. I didn't touch...
Did you ever touch your 4-year-old granddaughter for your own sexual gratification?
Here it is.
He answered no. He did not tell the truth.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
The only reason why he got away with you was because you were intoxicated. But with the child, how innocent, right?
She didn't know. She didn't even think it was a bad thing.
Right. 4 years old.
She was doing it to me.
You know what?
It's disgusting.
You are one of the sickest bastards I've ever had stand on my stage.
And I agree.
You should not be walking around a free society. You truly are one of the guys that been on my stage that needs to be behind bars for a long time. You sick bastard, get the hell off my stage.
Bye, forever.
Because what he did to you and what he did to your daughter is despicable.
And it's not going to stop.
I wish you all the luck in the world. If we can help in any way, and please let us know what happens with the investigation, what happens with John.
I will for sure.
Thank you, Steve. We appreciate you. You do a great job.
Thank you, and thanks for coming.
I was right.
My name is Steve Wilkos, and I'm an investigative talk show host with a law enforcement background.
It was my life or his.
My job is to get truth and justice for everyday people. Watch our videos now.